Welcome back to another video. Today we're playing some Clash of Clans Legends. I'm going to show you this Super Archer Blimp, which is an awesome strategy to try out. So we have AMC Mr. Hope here, and we're gonna drop our Lava Hound in our Blimp, and we hopefully try to get close to the Town Hall as possible. Okay, so let's go. This will defend the Blimp and catch all of those mines. This base is not that good for this attack, so we might struggle a bit. We're gonna drop our clones and our invisibility spells for our super archers. And it should shred up this corner of the base. Timing is very important here, making sure to place the invisibility spells and not letting them die. I don't know if we'll get the town hall here. That's what it's been. So we got the single and the town hall, which is awesome for this strategy. I am running the Electro Titan Pekka Smash. So we're gonna drop this Titan to kill the skeletons, and then we're gonna funnel everything in. Okay, the healers are coming in, everything's looking good. Hopefully we're gonna drop this champion here to funnel everything into the center of the base. Drop this headhunter for the royal champion, super wall break in. Put this wizard here on one of the sides. This strategy just basically entails the funneling into the center of the base, well-timed warding ability to make sure the barbarians are invincible along with the champion. And we just have the monolith to worry about, and the multi should not even harm these titans here. So it should be a 3-star, just the enemy team might be a little reckoning, but so we got this. We got the Titan, the Pekka, Queen ability. Should be good here. Hopefully don't time fail here. We only have 3 buildings here, but breaking through the walls is very tough. We can take down our Pekka, which sucks. With the Queen ability here, she should be easy to take down. And we're gonna kill these 2 Teslas really fast, and we will not time fail. Awesome. That's a easy 40 trophies for today. On to the next attack. Running the same strategy here with a more center bait. Center town hall, so we will be having better value here. So we're gonna do the same thing, Lava Hound covering the Blimp, and we're gonna drop it as close as we can to the town hall without the super archers dying from the blast. So his ability goes down, rage, and the clones will go down as soon as the goblins and wall breakers clear from the clan castle. So we're gonna clone the wrong thing. So the invisibilities last 4 seconds, making sure to place them down every 4 seconds would be good. And we're taking down this town hall, even though there was that spell tower with invisibility. The awesome value here, taking down the monolith, the town hall, the queen. We just have the single to worry about and the heroes. Our troops are very tanky, so we're gonna funnel this left side here, and then we're gonna drop all the heroes in. Headhunter to kill the king faster. So once the super goblin breaks the liquid plug and funnels down the side, we're gonna super wall break in and drop everything in the base. And we're gonna super wall break into the scattershot compartment, leaving everything in. But our Pekka's and our Electrotine's doing right now is not good, so we're gonna break them, wall break them in here to attack them to the center of base more. The Champion will funnel down the top side, forcing everything into the center. And let's hope this attack goes well. Look at that Diggy. Awesome, stunning. There's a tower. We have this town, enemy clan castle coming out. A little annoying, and that single is a little, it's gonna kill our Electro-Titan. Oh, it's getting switched off. And the Ice Golem breaks, which is awesome. We have the Queen ability, but we were not meant to use it, which is fine. And our Yak is still alive, so it should break us into this point. Oh. So the Inferno's only on a Warden, this kinda sucks. But I still think this should be a 3-star. Our Queen should go for the Inferno Tower before it kills everything. But that Inferno Tower is super annoying. Look at that, it killed two of our big troops. This strategy is awesome. You can incorporate the Super Archer Blimp into almost every attack. Just see Blimp first, and then you send in your troops afterwards. You can hit them with Hydra, Lalo, Smash, Super Bowlers. Probably not Super Bowlers, but other Smash attacks should be good. But people are countering this attack much more with those double poison towers, so it's going to be more tough. Now I'll show you this attack with Lalo. So we're going to Super Archer Blimp with the Lava Hound ahead into the town hall. This base only has one multi, so we're trying to target that. The monolith isn't such as of a big of a threat compared to the last attack, which has a lot of tanks, and the monolith kills those tanks really fast. So we're gonna send our Blimp in, do the invisibility, rage, clone, classic stuff. Dropping the Blimp before the air sweeper pushes the Blimp back, and waiting for all the troops to clear. We'll use our clone so we don't reclone the archers only. We're gonna place the invisibility down every 4 seconds, making sure to protect the archers as best as possible. Looks like we got the town hall and the monolith, which is awesome. Let's see what else we can get. Looks like we're just gonna get the wizard tower, I think. And that's some pretty good value. What we're gonna do is do the Hero Sui in to cut down one of the sides. And then we're gonna Lalo along the side of them to give them support. So we're gonna place our king down at the bottom to defend those sides down. And we're gonna use our Electro Titan for the Kang Castle in case there's a Lava Hound. This queen might be good, but we're gonna have to use her ability, but it's gonna take down the Scatter Shot and that Royal Champion, which is good for our Lalo. Good thing we have that Electro Titan for that Lava Hound. I don't know if the Lava Hound's gonna go for the Electro Titan. Champion down at the bottom to funnel in the sides. That's a pretty bad champion on my end. He's gonna die really fast. But let's send our Lalo in with our Headhunter to take down the queen. An instability here as we enter that multi to protect some of these balloons. Not much splash damage left in the base, other than wizard towers. But the air defense might be a little problematic, but we still have our champion cutting down some of the defenses. Champion goes down, but we're gonna send some balloons here on the side to help take down the air defense. Just putting our cleanup troops at the end to help save a time fail. And we're gonna place these balloons on the back end while their other air targeting defenses are targeting a big group of balloons. Looks like we are supposed to get a 3-star. Nice. Might be a little close, but I think we got the 3-star. This is the example with Super Archer Lalo. But as time goes on, people are adapting their bases. They're using two poison towers, and this strategy is being nerfed. So let's do this Electro Titan Smash again. We're gonna use our Super Archer Blimp, targeting the Town Hall and trying to hit the Monolith and the Single. Those are the big point damage defenses. Oh, that's not good, but our Blimp should still be fine. It's awesome. Invisibility. And then we're gonna clone once the troops clear and rage. And the Archer Towers, Super Archers are going to town here. And we get so much value. I don't think we're gonna get the Monolith, but we will get the Single, which is nice. And what's so good about having a Titan is that we can kill the Lava Hounds real easily. And it looks like we do get the Monolith, which is awesome. I'm gonna funnel down the sides here. And we're gonna smash into the top, I think. We're gonna place our Electro Titan down to kill the pups. Look at that. Awesome. And because our troops are going to the top base, and we're gonna come down the left side a bit so we can send our troops in. And it should be a nice line down to the eagle and turning right around the base. Coco Loon's down to take some black mines just in case to protect the healers. Wizard hopefully funneling down the left side and sending our headhunters in for that quadruple hero compartment. The warden ability protecting everything basically. We still have a lot of base left, so it's not looking that good. We used up almost all of our abilities, and hopefully we can have enough power to get through all of that. We have scatters, expos, and multi. Might be a little tough. Oh, that's a nice diggy. Stun the scatter. So nice. The multi is problematic. Look at that warden just like eating that Inferno Tower. It's awesome. Not really stupid, but. And with 30 seconds left, might be tough to finish this attack. Looks like we're gonna time fail here. 20 seconds to kill all that. A little tough. Our troops made it through because we killed all of the large damage, but I do not think we're going to get this. It's going to be close. 5 seconds. We definitely do not have this. That was close though, but 99%, 32 trophies. Thank you guys for watching. Have a nice day.